time.
It's so disturbing how little understanding they have of where this plays out. And that censorship in any form, whether you censor someone who you don't like Milo Yiannopoulos, it will eventually lead to someone who's less offensive than him, and then less offensive than them, and then less offensive than them, and it'll go to you. It will come for you. It will eventually come for you. You will say something wrong. You will support something that they don't agree with, and whoever has the power to censor will deplatform you. They will remove you if we allow this. And we're in this weird place in America where a lot of people are looking at these social media companies and saying this is not as simple as this is a private company and they have the ability to choose who does and who doesn't use their platform. These things are like a public square. These things are like a utility. It's like electricity or water, and it's something that everyone should have access to because it literally changes the way human beings view the world. It changes with people's contributions and with people's ability to express themselves. It changes the information that you gather. It changes whether or not someone's perspective resonates with you or not. If you don't get access to that perspective, you don't get to see it. You don't get to understand their point of view. And it changes the overall view of the world. And this is where we are. We're in this weird place where these groups of people who are largely on the left have decided to abandon those values that you talked about, the original ACLU values, and they've chosen to instead be ideological and completely biased to their own personal position, to the point where they're willing to abandon free speech. And it's terrifying because I don't think they understand where this leads. I don't think they've done the math. I don't think they've extrapolated.
They can't think 2 seconds in front of their faces. You know, one of the things that's so bizarre is if you asked, you know, like a random leftist, what do you think of Facebook? They'll say, oh, I think Mark Zuckerberg is a fascist piece of shit. And then you say, like, what do you think of the federal courts in the United States? And they'll say, oh, it's completely repressive. They're like filled with right-wing judges, which is true. And you say, like, what do you think of the U.S. government? Oh, the U.S. government is basically a fascist dictatorship. It's run by Donald Trump. And then you say, are you in favor of giving those institutions, Facebook, the federal courts, the US government, greater power to censor ideas and information that you don't like? And they'll say, yeah, absolutely. It's critical that hate speech not be circulated. And they never fucking think for 1 second, why are these institutions that I hate and I think are fascist and repressive and authoritarian, institutions that I'm willing to vest the power in to control the flow of information? And one of the problems is that everyone, you know, for the most part, thinks in terms of right versus left. So this is the only prism through which people can understand at least the political component of the world. And it's a very stunted prism because it excludes so much. So they think that if you can induce social media companies to start censoring and excluding right-wing speech and deleting the pages of right-wing ideologues or right-wing activists, that's a victory. But that isn't how it works. They're not censoring it because it's right-wing. They're censoring it because it's outside of the mainstream. They're always, 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 views that adhere to mainstream orthodoxies are going to be permitted. Censorship is always directed at those who are somehow outside of the realm of what's considered acceptable by power centers. That, by definition, is where censorship goes, and it's going to go to the right and the left equally. It's not going to go to one or the other. It's the most, aside from the morality and the ethics of wanting people with whom you disagree silenced by tech monopolies, It's just incredibly fucking stupid from a strategic perspective because it is going to be turned on you. Without doubt, it already is. There's already censorship of left-wing pages. If the Israeli government, for example, goes to Facebook and says that Palestinian media outlet or this Gazan activist is inciting terrorism, Facebook will, in almost every case, accept the request of the Israelis to censor them because the Israelis are much more powerful than the Palestinians, and that's how corporations operate. This is the model, the framework that the left is empowering without realizing how self-destructive it is. It's maddening and it is terrifying because all human history, the entire history of human intellect, is nothing but humans believing that they found some absolute truth and then a subsequent generation realizing that it's not just erroneous, but morally rotten. And if you preclude the ability of human beings to question and challenge every precept, every principle, including or especially the ones that have been declared most sacred, the ones that have been declared most unchallengeably true, you've deprived humanity of one of its most important weapons, probably its most important one, for fostering progress, for combating despotism, for questioning the pronouncements of institutions of authority. And that's what people who think they're anti-authoritarian are doing.
I'm so